and I almost jumped. A man had come up to the alcove. He was looking at us inquiringly, with one hand on the curtain.
"Your pardon if I'm intruding," he observed. "Louise, I don't believe I know..."
She nodded towards us, quite self-possessed again.
"Oh, yes. These are gentlemen from the police, Edouard. Allow me to present Monsieur Edouard Vautrel."
Vautrel bowed. He was a tall man with waved blonde hair and an eye aggressively hypnotic. Wide nostrils flared above a narrow mustache. The face was lined in wrinkles and smelled of astringence. His bow suggested the soldier and the corset. There was a sort of heavy poise about the way he toyed with a monocle on a black ribbon.
"Very happy," he murmured and hesitated.
Benkelin mentioned the weather. I noticed that in acknowledging the introduction, he had not even looked at Vautrel. He was sitting bolt upright, and ever since he had seen the Duc de Saligny go through that far door into the card room, he had not moved his eyes from the door. He added, still with that gaze of intense speculation on the card room door,
"Madame, even though you suffered an hallucination, how did you recognize Laurent? Was his appearance changed? We have reason to think so."
"I don't know. It was an impression. I just saw him in that half light. Certain gestures, the way he opened his eyes. I don't know. I could not be deceived if I saw him."
Vautrel smiled sourly and said with deprecating petulance,
"Oh, come, why encourage this brooding, monsieur? You all act as though you were afraid of this man. I've seen half a dozen minions of the law hanging about this place. Ridiculous, all this fuss. Louise, Raoul's gone to the card room,"
he added abruptly.